logical reasoning. The first question, find the mirror image of the given figure. Okay, what is a mirror image? In mirror image, the right side of the object becomes the left side. The left side of the object becomes the right side. Then the top and bottom sides of the object remain unchanged. Okay, here the given figure contains three letters, S, O, F. We need to find the mirror image of these letters, right? So, what is the mirror image for S? The left become right and right become left. So, S will be look like this in mirror. Right? Okay. Then next, O. The mirror image of O is the same letter itself, right? Similar. So, O will be like this in mirror. Then F. The right side part will become left. So, it will be like this. So, option A is the correct answer. If a triangle is called a square and square is called a cone and cone is called a rectangle, then dash is a solid shape. What do you call a solid shape? A three-dimensional shape can be defined as a solid figure or solid shape, right? What is three-dimensional? It must have length, width and height. So among all the figures or all the shape, triangle, square, cone and rectangle, cone is a three-dimensional figure called as a solid shape, right? Cone is a solid shape. Here cone is called as rectangle. So rectangle is a solid shape. Option C is the correct answer. If the day after tomorrow will be Sunday, then the day before yesterday was. Okay. So the day after tomorrow will be Sunday. Then what is today? What is the day today? Today is Friday. Okay, then the day before yesterday. The day before yesterday was Wednesday. Okay, so option A is the correct answer. Which of the following figures will complete the pattern in the given figure? We need to find this part, right? Okay, so now we check the option one by one. Option A, so if we take this part, right, this square part, here the square part is filled with some color, so option A is wrong. Next, option B, if we take option B means, okay, that circle part is not filled with the color, so option B is wrong. Here all the, here total circle will filled with some color, right? Okay, then option C. In option C, this straight line is not filled with the color. So, option C is totally wrong. And option D, yes, this line is filled with the color. And the sides of the square is not filled with the color, yes. And the part of the circle is filled with the color, yes. So, option D is the correct answer. Okay, in how many different ways can Manav reach to the library? So one by one we'll check. So if we take this way means, yes, this is one, and he may go like this, 1, 2, this is a second way, then this is third way, then this is fourth way, then he may go like this, and this is fifth way. So totally all the lines are covered. So five different ways Manav can reach to the library. So option A is the correct answer. Next comes science. Study the given relationship between the plant parts that are edible and select the option that shows the same relationship. The given relationship is turmeric, carrot and cauliflower. Okay, in turmeric the edible part is root. The root of the plant is called as rhizome. Then carrot, the edible part is root. And in cauliflower, the edible part is, it's a stem. It's a stem vegetable. Okay. So the same relationship which satisfies the relation is option A. Ginger. The edible part of ginger is again rhizome of the plant, that is called stem. In potato, the edible part is root. And for cabbage, It's a stem vegetable. Right. So option A is the correct answer. P shows how each living organism gets its food and how they depend on each other for fulfillment of their food requirements. Then P is called, it's called as food chain. What is a food chain? If one living organism eats another organism, and later that organism is consumed by another living organism, and it goes on, right? So that flow of nutrients and energy from one organism to another at different trophic levels forms a food chain. So then P must be a food chain. Option B is the correct. The type of food shown in the picture may belong to a bird that has a broad and flat beak with holes on either side, makes its nest by scraping piles of mud, has strong, sharp and hooked beak, and has a fifth toe called spur. Okay, just look into the picture, right? So this part is talon, right? This is talon, and these nails called as claws, right? It's as a sharp claws. This is sharp claws. Okay, this strong and sharp claws to catch and hold their prey while flying, right? So the mostly the claws of preying birds are called talons. Okay, what are all the preying birds, you know? For example, eagles and vultures, hawks, and some more birds are in there, right? Preying birds, right? Okay, how it looks, the preying bird looks like, how it must be strong and it has sharp and hooked beak. So option C is the correct answer. Which of the following food items is generally made by baking? Okay, option C, the food item cake is made by baking process. Option C is the correct answer. Which of the following on unscrambling gives the name of temporary houses, right? Okay, what is temporary houses? The temporary houses are kutcha houses, right? Kutcha houses. Okay, now we unscramble the given words. This is caravan. Yes, it is a one type of temporary houses, caravan. Here, this is hut. Hut is one type of temporary houses. Then this is apartment. And this is bungla. Right. Okay, which is the exact correct answer? Whether it is a caravan or hut. What is a hut? A hut is a kutcha house. Okay. So people will live there for a short period of time. Right. They build houses that can be moved from one place to another, right? Then what is caravan? Caravan, so gypsies lives in houses on wheels called caravan. So it can be easily moved from one place to another. So the exact answer for this question is caravan. Okay, select the option which consists of rail, water and air transport respectively. First we have to find the mode of transport of each option, right? So first option, a lorry, ship, tractor. But lorry and tractor both are land, right? So here they have not asked for land mode of transport, right? So option A is wrong. Then coming from the B, train, yes it is rail. Then boat, it is water. Mode of transport is water. And helicopter, is mode of transport is air. So option B is the correct answer. Select the option that correctly classify the organs on the basis of the system they belongs to. So three system as given: digestive, excretory and nervous system. Okay, coming to the option A, stomach is a digestive system, yes. And kidney, yes, it's a excretory system. And blood vessel, it is not the part of nervous system. Okay, then option B, liver is a digestive system, no. So total option B is wrong. Next coming to the option C, it's a small intestine is a digestive system, part of a digestive system. And heart, is heart a excretory system? No. So option C is also wrong. Then coming to the option D, food pipe, yes, digestive system. It's a part of a digestive system, yes. Then ureter is a part of the excretory system. Yes. Then brain. Yes. Is a part of the nervous system. So option D is the correct answer. Study the given Venn diagram and select the option that correctly identifies X. The two circles are given, astronaut and member of Apollo 11 team, and two circles are interrelated at the part of X, and we need to find what is X. X must be Kalpana Chawla or Neil Armstrong or Rakesh Sharma or Sunita Williams. It must be B, Neil Armstrong. Why? Because it's Apollo 11 was the first manned mission to land on the moon. So Neil Armstrong is the correct answer. Option B. Select the option that correctly fills the empty boxes in the given classification chart. Okay, types of food flowchart is given here. There are three types of food is there: energy giving food, bodybuilding food and protective food. What is energy giving food? It's a carbohydrate. And next is bodybuilding food is rich in proteins. Then what is protective food? A food which contains adequate amount of minerals and vitamins. Right, minerals and vitamins. Okay, so coming to the option B is the correct answer. Why? Because bread is a carbohydrate and meat is rich in protein and papaya is rich in vitamins. So option B is the correct answer. Okay, four objects P, Q, R and S of different weights are put into a tank of water. The given diagram shows what happens when they are in water. Okay, the object R is floating slightly up the level of object Q. Right, up the level of object Q, thus it must be lighter than Q. But it is floating slightly lower the level of object P. Right, thus it must be heavier than P. Hence, the weight of object R must be between 30 gram to 37 gram. It must be between the weight of the object R. So by seeing this option B, 35 gram is the weight of the object R. So option B is the correct answer. Which of the following is a pleasant sound? Okay, option A, sound made by crackers. B, honking of vehicles. C, stripping of birds. And D, screaming by a girl. Option C, stripping of birds is a pleasant sound. Option C is the correct answer. Match the column and select the correct option. Option A, diamond. Diamond is used as a jewel. And coal. Coal used in thermal power plants. Graphite. The graphite is used in pencil. The next come pumice. What is pumice? It's a stone which is used to remove dry and dead skin. So it is used as a body scrubber. So option D is the correct answer. Das is the brightest planet of the solar system. Venus is the brightest planet of the solar system. Why? Because Venus is the second planet from the sun and which reflects the sun rays, making the planet the brightest in the night sky. So option B is the correct answer. Select the incorrect match. Here some tools and professionals are given. We have to find which option is wrongly matched. Okay, so the tailor. Yes, tailor will use needle and thread. And mechanic, yes, mechanical is will use spanner. And cobbler, a shoemaker, will use a shoe stand. Yes. And farmer will not use a paintbrush. So it is wrongly matched. So option D is the correct answer for the given question. Which of the following activities does not recover water? The given options are bathing, cooking, drying of wet cloths and washing clothes. So option A, B and D requires water, and for drying of wet clothes water does not require, right? So option C is the correct answer. Baby of which of the following animal is called a cuff? Okay, here the baby dog is called as puppy, and the baby goat is called as kid, and the baby elephant is called as cuff. Then baby kangaroo is called as Joyce, right? So option C is the correct answer. Read the given statement and select the option that correctly identifies true and false ones. Okay, the given statements are: people who do more physical work need more carbohydrate-rich food. Yes, it gives more energy. Intake of more carbohydrate gives more energy. So the statement one is true. Next, minerals helps in the formation of bones, teeth and blood. Yes, true. Eating too much of roughage containing food can make you obese. No. So taking more fiber, it will not make you obese. So here the statement is false. So option is B is the correct answer. TTF. Which of the following festival is a harvest festival? Option B is the correct answer. Pongal. Monali has noted down 9th March as new moon in her calendar. Which phase of the moon would she most likely observe on 23rd March? Okay, so the 9th March is, it's a new moon day. Okay, so every 15 days it will change, right? So 9th March is new moon, means after 15 days. After 15 days is, it is 23rd March, right? So 23rd March will be a full moon day. Option C is the correct answer. Sakshi, while driving, she is the given road sign. She should. Okay. The given road sign shows the stop blowing horn. So option B is the correct answer. Unscramble the given letters to obtain the name of a season. Now select the clothing item that is most suitable to be worn in this season. Okay, now we'll arrange this jumble words. Okay, if we arrange these jumble words, we'll get a meaningful word, winter. So winter is a season. During winter season, we wear woolen cloths. That is option A. Select the option that pairs a shrub and a climber. Okay, we'll check the option one by one. Jasmine P. Yes, jasmine is a shrub and P is a climber. Okay, option A is the correct answer, and we'll check the rest of the option also. Rose is a shrub, but pumpkin is a creeper. As well as spinach, it is a herb, and watermelon is a creeper. And mint and rice, both are herbs. So option A is the correct answer. First letter, strike out every alternate letter to get the name of X. Which of the following organs helps in X? Okay, now let us find the name of X. Starting from the first letter, we have to strike out. Then O. O. P. Z. X. N. B. A. T. J. So the rest of the letter is S. M. E. L. L. I. N. G. It is smelling. Which of the organs helps in X? Nose. So option A is the correct answer. Which of the following objects can hurt you if used? Okay, so first one is, it's a powder, face powder. Second option is soap, and third one is a broken glass, and fourth one is a toothpaste. So if you use a broken glass, means it will hurt, right? So option C is the correct answer. The question is, I am a means of land transport. I have three wheels and I run by manpower. Okay, who am I? The first option, sledge. Second one is bullock cart. Third one is auto rickshaw, and option D is a cycle rickshaw. Okay, I have three wheels and I run by manpower. Okay, bullock cart, it will not come. It does not have three wheels. And auto rickshaw, yes, it has three wheels. And cycle rickshaw, it is three wheels. Then what is a sledge? Sludge is also a land vehicle that slides across a surface, usually on ice or snow, right? So it will also not come. So which one is, auto rickshaw or cycle rickshaw? So cycle rickshaw requires a manpower to run and also has a three wheels. So option D is the correct answer. Achiever section. The first question, refer to the given table. Select the option that correctly identifies W, X, Y, and Z. Here is the tabular column. In the tabular column, the characteristics of four living organisms has been given here, right? So we need to find the name of all the four organisms. First option A, in that the name of the organism for W is snake. Okay, so now we'll match the characteristics of the snake. Snake lays eggs? Yes. Snake only eats flesh of other animals? Yes, because it is a carnivore. Then snake breathes through lungs? Yes. Snake cannot fly? Yes, it is true. So the characteristics of snake is correct here. Then we'll go for the next organism X, frog. Frog lays eggs, but it is given here does not lay eggs. But frog lays eggs, so option A is wrong here. Then we'll move on to the next option B, bat. Okay, so for that we have to check W. Bat lays eggs? No, bat is a mammal. So but here they have given us bat lays eggs. So option B is also wrong. The next C, option C, frog. Frog lays eggs? Yes. Frog only eats flesh of other animals? Yes, it is a carnivore. Then frog breathes through lungs? Yes. Frogs cannot fly? Yes. Okay, so the name, the given characteristics for the frog is correct. Then we'll move on to the next one, bear. Okay, for this we have to check in the X. Okay, bear lays eggs? No. Okay, it is correct only. Then bear only eats flesh of other animals? No, it is an omnivore. It will eat both plants and animals, but here they are given only eats flesh of other animals. So option C is wrong. So only one option is left over, that is option D. For that we have to check all the names, all the organisms we have to check. Crocodile. Crocodile will lay eggs? Yes. It only eats flesh of other animals? Yes. Then crocodile breathe through lungs? Yes. And crocodile cannot fly? Okay, it is correct. Then cheetah. Cheetah does not lay eggs. Okay, correct. Then cheetah eats only flesh of other animals? Yes. And cheetah breathe through lungs? Yes. Cheetah cannot fly? Okay, it is correct. Then butterfly. So butterfly lays eggs? Right. Butterfly only eats flesh of other animals? No, it is correct here. Then butterfly breathe through lungs? No, it is also correct here. Then butterfly can fly? Yes. So the organism Y is butterfly here. Then Z is a crow. Crow lays eggs, right? Crow only eats flesh of other animals? No. Okay, here also correct. Crow breathe through lungs? Yes. And crow can fly? Yes. So the name of the organism Z is crow. So finally option D is the correct answer. Which of the following figures correctly represents the nutrient composition of whole grain wheat flour? Okay. What is the major nutrient present in the whole grain wheat flour? It's a carbohydrate, right? So there's a major nutrient. The composition is greater than the other nutrients, right? So option B is the correct answer, because here carbohydrate composition is greater than the other nutrients like fat and protein. So option B is the correct answer. Study the given flowchart and identify P, Q, R and S. The flowchart starts with the matter. What is a matter? A matter can be a solid or liquid or gas. Okay. The next, the object has a fixed shape. So if the object has a fixed shape, means it must be a solid. Okay, if not, means it could be either liquid or gas. So the object P must be a liquid or gas. We'll move on to the option. Kerosene, oxygen, milk, honey. Okay, kerosene, milk, honey, all are liquid and oxygen is a gas. So the name of P can be either of this, right? It can be anyone, no problem. Then we'll move on to the next object, Q. Then for this we'll again go through the flowchart. An object has a fixed shape. Yes, it is a solid. If it is a solid, means it should allow the light to pass through. Okay, but the object Q is a solid, but it does not allow light to pass through. Q is a solid, but it does not allow light to pass through. So for this we'll check in the option chair. Chair is a solid. It does not allow light to pass through. Okay. Then nitrogen. Nitrogen is a solid? No. So here itself option B is totally out of form. Next, cardboard. Cardboard is a solid? Yes. It It allows light to pass through? No, it does not allow light to pass through. Then water vapor. Water vapor is a gaseous form. So option D is won't be the answer. So either of this, either A or C, right? It could be chair or cardboard for the name of Q. Then we'll move on to the object R, finding the R. Again, we'll go through the flowchart. A matter is a solid shape. That particular solid allows a light to pass through. That object can break easily. If not, we cannot able to break easily that particular object, right? So R is a solid and it allows light to pass through, but we cannot able to break it easily. Then we'll move on, then we'll check the option here. Again, cellophane paper, right? Cellophane paper is a solid. It allows light to pass through, but we can easily tear that cellophane paper, right? Then tire. So, okay, sorry. Next, clear plastic sheet. Clear plastic sheet is a solid. Then it will allows light to pass through. Then we can able to break the clear plastic sheet very easily? No. Right? So, we cannot able to break the clear plastic sheet. So, R must be a clear plastic sheet. So finally, option C is the correct answer because cellophane paper is wrong. So C must be the answer. Then we'll check the rest of the object S also. What is S? Again, we'll go through the flowchart again. Solid, particular object is a solid and it allows light to pass through. Yes, and it can easily break. That means it is a glass bowl. Yes, glass bowl is a solid and it has a fixed shape. And it allows the light to pass through and it can easily break. So finally, C is the correct answer. Refer to the given word grid. Which of the following means of transport is not hidden in this word grid? Okay, option A, means of transport used to carry sick and injured people to hospital. It is ambulance. So ambulance is here. Next, means of water transport used by naval forces. We have two answers here. One is boat and another one is submarine. So, submarine is the exact answer. So, naval forces will use the submarine as a water transport. The next, means of public land transport that runs on electricity. The transport name is, it's a rail or train, right? Rail or train. Then we'll check in the grid. So in the grid we don't have the word rail or train. Okay, we'll move on to the next option D. Means of transport used by astronauts to go into space, right? We have two options. One is rocket, another one is space shuttle. Okay, we'll check it to the grid also. Then we have, yes, yeah, rocket is there, right? So there is, there can be two answers, rocket or space shuttle, but rocket is here. So option A, B and D, we can able to find the word in the grid, but in for C, that word is not in the grid. So option C is the correct answer. Study the Venn diagram about heavenly bodies and select the correct statement regarding it. Okay, here the Venn diagram is given. Three circles are interrelated and some parts are interrelated, right? Okay, so we have to find the names of X, Y and Z. Okay, starting with X. First circle, second circle and third circle. X is a part of first circle. Yes, life exists here and X is a part of revolves around the sun in its orbit and X is a part of reflects light of the sun. What could be the answer? X must be Earth because in Earth only life exists, right? And Earth revolves around the sun in its orbit and Earth reflects light of the sun. So option B is the answer. Straight away we can go for B because X contains Earth. And you can check other option. A, here the name of X is Venus. And C, the name of X is Mars. And D, the name of X is Jupiter. So obviously A, C, D are odd one out, right? So B must be the answer. Then we'll check the rest of the names Y and Z also. Mercury. Okay, the Mercury is the very closest planet to the sun. And it has an orbit and around the sun, right? So Mercury revolves around the sun in its orbit and it reflects the light of the sun. So Y must be Mercury. Then Set is the particular planet reflects light of the sun. So which planet reflects light of the sun also? Then Moon. So Z must be moon. So option D is the correct answer.